Hi, welcome to Street Priest Ministries. I'm your host, Brother Jay, where we're taking the Gospels back to the streets. Today's drive-through message is A Jackass Preaches. Turn in your Bibles to Numbers 22. Now, this message was inspired by a jackass. So, I thought I'd teach him. He was critical. He said, you know, man, in order for me to listen to you, you got to take them shades off. I got to see the whites of your eyeballs. I said, look, jackass, the word of God comes through a jackass. You better listen. Don't matter what the vehicle God chooses to deliver the message. It's the message important. You can forget about Brother Jay. Who cares about him? It's the message you shouldn't forget. So that's why this was inspired. God got the inspiration all through his book. Most people don't read it. But we're going to read it. Numbers 22. We'll start there. And God's teaching here is irrelevant. Now, the messenger is the message. Now, we're going to learn here. In Numbers. Well, see, you know, today you got a lot of jackasses that are preaching. In his day, it was a miracle for a jackass to speak. Now it's a miracle for a jackass to shut up. So turn to Numbers 22. Now, give you a quick backdrop. This guy is a guy named Balak. He's the king of Moabs, of the Moabites. Balak is his name. He hires a wizard, a very powerful wizard, Balaam. And this wizard, you've got the genuine deal in sorcery, witches and warlocks or wizards. In Deuteronomy 18, God forbade his people to mix with this crowd, period. But this guy is a hired gun, a hired wizard. And his own, see, if you would, you know, greater is he that is us than he in the world. Let me speak that first. I've encountered real wizards and real witches in my life. I mean, the real deal, Holyfield. But you know, they run like hell from a true man of God. I've had one literally disappear, literally, and cry out. So greatest heat is nuts in his world. Let me state that. There ain't no curses or anything they can put on us that is effective. Because we're covered by the blood of Jesus Christ. So, you know, you don't have to worry about that as a saint. But to get back to this, he hired them to curse the children of Israel. He hired this wizard. And this is a very powerful wizard. So without the protection of God, his curse would have worked, is what I'm trying to say. Remember we studied in the four great prophets about the wizards of Egypt? They just went toe-to-toe with Moses up to a certain point, and after that, they said, we can't go no further. Their power is limited. The man of God kept on going right until the end, until he destroyed them. They tried to warn the Pharaoh, say, hey, this is the finger of God here. So let's study this jackass. Now, and the children of Israel set forward and pitched in the plains of Moab on the side of Jordan by Jericho. And Balak, the son of Zippor, saw all that the Israel had done to the Amorites. And God, they saw how God had enabled them to wipe the Amorites out. And Moab was so afraid of the people because they were many. And Moab was distressed because of the children of Israel. Now remember, God said, I'm going to bring you into their territories to wipe them out. To kill off all the ites and the parasites and this and that. I'm going to give you the land. So say he had probable cause to be afraid. And Moab said to the elders of Midian, Now shall this company lick up all that is around about us, as the ox licketh up the grass of the field. And Balak the son of Zippor was king of the Moabites at the time. He sent messengers, therefore, unto Balaam, the son of Beor, of Pethor. Now this is the wizard, Balaam, which is by the river of the land of the children of his people, to call him, saying, Behold, there is a people come up out from Egypt. Behold, they cover the face of the earth, and they abide over against me. Come now, therefore, I pray thee, curse this people, for they are too mighty for me. Maybe I shall prevail, that we may smite them. He said, if you curse them and weaken them with your curse, wizard Balaam, that we'd be able to take them on. And that I may drive them out of the land, for I would not he whom thou blessed is blessed. He said, I heard whoever you bless is blessed, and whoever you curse is cursed. And whom thou bless is blessed, and whom thou cursed is cursed. And the elders of Moab and the elders of Midian departed with the rewards of divination. See? The rewards of divination, witchcraft, sorcery. So he brought this wizard in to curse God's people. Rewards of divination in their hand. And they came unto Balaam, and to make unto him the words of Balaam. And he said unto them, Lodge here this night, and I will bring you word again, as the Lord shall speak unto me. And the princes of the Moab abode with Balaam. And God came unto Balaam and said, What men are these with thee? And Balaam said unto God, Balak the son of Zippor, the king of Moab, hath sent unto me, saying, Behold, there is a people come out of Egypt, which covereth the face of the earth. Come now, curse me them. Maybe I shall be able to overcome them and drive them out. And God said unto Balaam, Thou shalt not go with them. Thou shalt not curse the people, for they are blessed. And Balaam rose up in the morning and said unto the princes of Balaam, Get out into your land, for the Lord refuses to give me leave to go with you. That's why he's Lord. He's Lord over everything. I told you that. We studied that in, over and over again. Take a look at Lucifer, the video. The devil has to answer to him. The wizards have to answer to the Lord. They can't do nothing without his permission. And the princes of Moab rose up, and they went unto Balak and said, Balaam refuses to come with us. And Balak sent yet again princes more and more honorable than they. And they came to Balaam and said to him, Thus said Balak, the son of Zippor, Let nothing, I pray thee, hinder thee from coming unto me, for I will promote thee unto a very great honor. He said, If you do this for me, I'll give you great honor. I'll give you a name in my kingdom. The people bow to you. For I will promote thee unto a very great honor, and I will do whatsoever thou sayest unto me. Come therefore, I pray thee, curse me this people. And Balaam answered and said unto the servants of Balak, If Balak would give me his house full of silver and gold, I cannot go beyond the word of the Lord my God to do less or more. Now therefore I pray you, tarry ye here also this night, that I may know what the Lord will say unto me more. And God came unto Balaam at night and said unto him, If the men come to call thee, rise up and go with them. But yet the word which I shall say unto thee, that shalt thou do. The word that I say unto thee, thou shalt do. And Balaam rose up in the morning and saddled his ass and went with the princes of Moab. And God's anger was kindled because he went, and the angel of the Lord stood in the way for an adversary against him. So he wanted to go his own way. Was this, as is it said again, class. I mean, we've covered this over. All we lack sheep. Turn straight, we go every man on way. That's just that said in a nutshell. So he decided to rebel against God's order. And God sent an angel out to stand in the pathway. Now, he was riding up on an ass. And his two servants were with him. And the ass saw the angel of the Lord standing in the way with his sword drawn. So the angel standing, blocking his path of travel with a sword drawn, ready to kill him. And the ass was a pretty smart ass. He was a smart ass. And the ass saw the angel of the Lord standing in the way, and his sword drawn in his hand. And the ass turned aside out of the way. Our ass is pretty smart. He said, man, I don't want none of this. This angel about to kill us. And the ass turned aside out of the way and went into the fields. And Balaam smote the ass. So Balaam started beating ass. He's giving his ass an ass beating. He's kicking his ass. To turn her into the way. But the angel of the Lord stood in the path of the vineyards. And a wall being on the side. So the angel stepped to him. This angel something else. Oh, the angel chasing Balaam. And he forced him into a tight spot here between the wall. And a wall on the side. And when the ass saw the angel of the Lord, she thrust herself into the wall. The angel's trying to get away from this sword. The angel said, I don't want to die for this fool. Balaam? The ass is trying to escape. Smart ass. And crushed Balaam's foot against the wall. So now his foot get crushed because the Balaam runs straight into the wall with Balaam on him. Because the ass is trying to avoid the angel with the sword. And he's beating his ass again. So he's giving his ass an ass beat. And he beat her again. And the angel of the Lord went further and stood in a narrow place where there was no way to turn either to the right hand or to the left. So now they're boxed in by the angel with the sword. No way to escape. Dead end alley. And when the ass saw the angel of the Lord, she fell down under Balaam. So the ass collapses. This ass is trying his best to save his life from this angel with the sword. And when the ass saw the angel of the Lord, she fell down up under Balaam. And Balaam's anger was kindled. He's pissed. Balaam's really mad. He said, this ass is out of control. And Balaam's anger was kindled, and he smote the ass with a staff. Now he's beating the ass with a stick. Talking about animal abuse here. Ass abuse. This is ass abuse. And the Lord opened the mouth of the ass. So now God's going to allow this ass to speak for itself. That's why the title of this, An Ass Preaches. A Jackass Preaches. And the Lord opened the mouth of the ass. And she said unto Balaam, what have I done unto thee? What do you beat me for, man? What have I done unto you? That thou hast smitten me these many times. You have beaten my ass. What have I done unto thee? That thou hast smitten me these three times. Why you beating me? And Balaam said unto the ass, now, this is a very interesting point. Me, I think I would have hobbled out of there with my one leg, because remember, his ankle's crushed now. I would have just got took off as soon as his ass started speaking. I say, either I'm crazy for hearing his ass talk to me. I got to get out of here, or something ain't right with this picture. This man talks to the ass like it's normal for a jackass to talk. And Balaam said unto the ass, because thou hast mocked me. He said, Man, you're making me a joke. I'm no joke. I'm trying to beat some sense into you, you ass. I would there were a sword in my hand, for now I would kill thee. He said, if I had a sword, I'll cut your head off, you ass. I cut the ass's head off. And the ass said unto Balaam, am I not thine ass? The ass is telling Balaam, I'm your ass. This ass belongs to you. Why are you abusing this ass? Ass abuse. I'm your ass. And the ass said unto Balaam, am I not thine ass? Open which thou hast written. Oh my God. Oh, am I not thine ass? So which thou hast written. I tell you, Bible's a very interesting book. If you could peel the traditional filters off of it. Great book to read. I love this book. My favorite book. It's got a lot of interesting stories in here. And the ass said unto Balaam, am I not thine ass, upon which thou hast ridden ever since I was thine until this day? I'm an ass that goes way back with you. We have a history here. It's a historical ass. This ass and him have a history together. And was I ever wont to do unto thee? Have I ever rebelled against you? Have I ever been a rebellious ass? No, I've been a very submissive ass. I'm the ass that's always been giving. I'm a giving ass. I'm submissive ass. I ever wont to do unto thee? And he said, no. He said, no. As a matter of fact, yeah, you have been a very submissive ass. Now that I think about it. Then the Lord opened the eyes of Balaam, and he saw the angel of the Lord standing in the way, and his sword drawn in his hand, and he bowed his head and fell flat on his face. And the angel of the Lord said unto him, wherefore hast thou smitten thine ass three times? Even the angels pissed off at him. God peeled his eyeballs back so he could see the danger he was really in. And the ass saved his life. And the angel of the Lord said unto him, wherefore hast thou smitten thine ass these three times? The angel said, animal abuse. I love animals. When I was raising my children, we had a yearly zoo pass. I used to take them to the zoo on a regular. I love animals. One time I took my kids to the zoo. And they had a jackass there. Jackass looked right at me, walked up to me, and started talking to me. I promise you, this is true. The jackass started braying. And I'm looking at this jackass, so I started braying back. And then me and this jackass had a conversation. And my children, you know, they were young. They were amazed. They said, oh, Daddy, you and the jackass are talking. I said, yeah, I guess so. I said, I guess the jackass likes me. It's a true story. This jackass was talking away. So that was my first experience with a talking jackass. And the angel of the Lord said unto him, wherefore hast thou smitten thine ass these three times? Behold, I went out to withstand thee, because thy way is perverse before me. And the ass saw me and turned from me these three times. Three is the number of divine manifestation. Unless ye had turned from me, and surely now also I had slain thee and saved her alive. He said, I wouldn't go kill the ass, but I would have killed your ass. And Balaam said unto the angel of the Lord, I have sinned. Oh, yeah. Angel said unto the Lord I have sinned, for I knew not that thou stoodest in the way against me. Now therefore, if it displease thee, I will get me back again. And the angel of the Lord said unto Balaam, go with the men, but only the word that I shall speak unto thee, that thou shalt speak. So Balaam went with the princes of Balak. And when Balak heard that Balaam was come, he went out. Now, that's all we're going to read there. I can fill in the rest of the story for you. So, Balaam, what he did do, and this is why he was hated in the Bible, because he was perverse. He still was still perverse. He gonna perverse person going to be perverse. The truth ain't going to really affect them. They're going to take it and twist it into whatever they want it to be. So he was unsalvageable. So what he did, he told Balak, he said, look, the prince, the king of Moab, he said, I can't curse these people, but what I can do is tell you how to seduce these people to worship idols. And if you do that, God will curse them himself, which is what happened. So that's why he's famous in the New Testament. I think it's the book of Jude talks about Balaam, the perverse one, that taught Israel to sin and to worship these false gods, mainly Baal and Asherah, which God hated, the satanic trinity and Talmud. So that's what he did do. Balaam led them into idol worship. He said, I can't curse them, but God will curse them for you. See, that's what Satan does. Satan will get you into a position where God curses you, and he won. That's pretty much the same with a robbing God. I mean, can't get off of that subject. You know, bring you all the tithes. He can get you in a cursed state, and you are, if you're a thief and a robber. Shall not bless. Satan has accomplished his mission. That's his mission. Now, in the law of the offerings dealing with the Bible calls man a wild ass. There's a reference throughout the scripture. It calls us a wild ass. And pride is just preening of the jackass. Where the jackass forgets he's a jackass. And in the law of the offerings, in the Levitical code, the firstborn jackass was to have his neck broke. Unless a lamb was sacrificed to save the jackass. Remember, Jesus rode a jackass with the palms that they put out in front of him into Jerusalem, symbolizing the only hope for a jackass is Jesus riding in the glory. Else you're a hopeless jackass on your way to hell. So I hope you learned something from this. And if I had a church, I would call it the First Church of the Jackass. That's what Brother Jay would name his church. First Church of the Jackass. We're all asses. We're jackasses. That's what God calls you. You got beautiful jackasses. You got ugly jackasses. You got bad jackasses. You got good jackasses. You got holy jackasses. First Church of the Jackass. That'd be my church. Forget all these flowery names. My church would be First Church of the Jackass. I hope you enjoyed this message. Don't be a jackass and rob God. Bring you all the tithes into the storehouse that they need in my house. Don't be a jackass that's robbing God. First fruits belong to the Lord as well as alabaster box. Hope you enjoyed this message and it's been a blessing to you. God bless you. And in Jesus' name, good day, good night, good evening to you around the world.